Sports Girl Cam, high atop the Hilton Bayfront Hotel, looking down over the Hard Rock Hotel. Can you see us? We're right on the corner. Has a guy that's from Almost Human a minute ago called me Inspector Gadget? Nope. I'm Tracy this morning, Erica.
I just got a text message saying, what are you? Come on now. Come on, people. The Queen of Hearts now. How exciting is this? We've been looking forward to this. Seriously, for quite some time.
Every hour we
tease it. We're
going
to be talking to you. David Boreanaz from Bones is here on our show right now. How pumped are you to be here?
It's always great to be here. I mean, you know, you get to run into Batman, you know, Superman, Queen of Hearts, right?
Inspector Gadget.
Yes, he called it right. First one to get it right this morning. Thank you, David.
To come here and interact with your fans who are so supportive and have been here for years for our show and whatnot. So we're really excited.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Anything that stands out to you so far?
Besides your yellow jumpsuit?
When you arrive in San Diego and you see the people, and all of a sudden you slowly see different types of characters walking around the town. It's always interesting and fun. So I've spotted a few so far. So it's just the energy's building.
Is there anybody here that's going to have you a little starstruck? Is there anybody here from any of the panels, anybody that would really just, get you excited if you saw any stars?
Yeah, SpongeBob SquarePants.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's
really?
The prelude to something.
Kids love them, so, you know, I don't know. There's always, I'm just happy to be here to do the panel with Bones, and we have some exciting news that we're going to announce at the panel.
What?
Which I can't tell you now.
Can you give us a hint?
All I can say is that...
Drop it, David. Come on, drop it.
It's going to be a conflicting year for Booth and Bones, but there's going to be something huge that's going to happen.
Well, let's talk about the Bones. Yes. Yeah. 9 seasons? Does it surprise you that it's been around for so long?
It's great. I mean, we're so fortunate and blessed to have such great writers and great showrunners and a great cast. And for us, we just do the episodes. We do the work, and we don't look any further beyond that. And it's hard to believe that we're going into our 9th season, and we're really blessed about that. Yeah.
I'm curious. You're going to be doing some signings today with your co-star. Tell me about that, if you would.
Yeah, we're going to be doing the panel. I think it's at 12:30, and then afterwards we'll be down at the floor doing some signings, so you can come by and you can meet Emily and myself and Hart Hansen and Ian Toynton, the two executive producers, and we'll be passing stuff out and whatever you want to say to us. Come down, ask questions, and we'll be there for you.
When you walk around, do you just get mobbed? I mean, is it like Brad Wills, where just people are...
Do you have your own security detail, David? What's going on?
I need a yellow hat. It'll be okay. Now that the yellow hat is on you, I'm gonna need security. No, we move fast. It's a fast, organized outfit here. I mean, you're timed back to back. You have to be one place and then the next place, so it goes by fast.
What about in the grocery store? Are they constantly coming up to you saying, you look sort of like
that?
Do you get that?
But I usually wear a Flyers hat or some kind of, you know, something, but they still, you know, recognize you. You know, he's 6'1", he's a tall guy, so, you know, I stand out a little bit.
Do you ever deny it? Are you like, yeah, I get that sometimes?
No, you know what? I embrace it, and I say, you know, how are you? Take a picture, whatever. It's very kind. I mean, look, I'm not going to run around with blinders on. I'm not going to change my life. I'm going to live like everybody else. I'm just fortunate to be working, and that's what I do.
Did you ever get, you look a lot like Brad Wills. Have you ever heard that before?
Yes, no.
Only when he wears a yellow trench
right,
coat.
Right, right.
This is really nice.
Can you talk about the fans and how, between Bones and Buffy?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
With that?
No, it's great. I mean, the fan base from Buffy's past and then Angel's past and then coupled with Bones' past, it's like the Buffyverse meets the Bonesheads and there's a clash right. of titans down on the floor and then security breaks out. It's a mess. But, you know, they've been with us since, I mean, we came here, I think, in 1997 with Joss and the whole group, and we were just a small cult show that just exploded. And here we are, you know, some years later, and everyone's gone on to different things and different paths, and we bump into each other. You know, today I'll probably run into Joss or maybe Allison, and, you know, we'll say hi and whatnot.
What is it about the show, you think, that creates such dedicated fans and made it just sort of blow up?
It's a story. It really comes down to storyline and characters and interactions, and really there's that romance and between the two characters. I mean, I know on Bones, with Emily and I, we really made it about the relationship, and that's really sustained us for 9 seasons now, and it's caught the hearts of many people across the world, so we're excited about that.
Where are the fans?
Yeah, it's caught the hearts.
Why do you think the fans are so loyal to you guys? What makes them keep coming back?
You know what? We put out good shows, and you know, I keep going back to the writing and the testimony to these people who create these stories. Mm-hmm. And we know we fill those gaps, and we play those characters, and we have a connection, and we share our relationship as characters to the people that are watching at home. And I think that resonates somehow.
David, how frequently do you watch the Fox 5 Morning News? Is it like every single day online? Is it every morning? I mean, is it like every other day, every morning,
much.
Afternoon, and night?
I mean, not as much as the NHL Network, but I will say that you may come in a close, distant third.
Okay, well, we do a thing called Dance Party Friday. Friday, where we get up and we move it and we dance. You gonna dance
with
us?
I'd love to dance with you guys.
He just volunteered to dance for Dance Party Friday. But before we get to that, how can people get a hold of you on social media? Are you tweeting? Are you Twitter?
I do have a Twitter account. It's David_Boreanaz. That's my Twitter handle, and that's how I communicate. I also communicate through Husay, and everyone's doing like Vine, and like I don't have an Instagram account, but I'm really kind of it's kind of interesting how this whole social media thing has blown up in the past 8 years. Like you can Vine me or at me or Twitter me. It's like everyone's got handles now. So, but yeah, that's how you can get to me.
Let's stand up. Do you have like a specific move, a dance move? Is there something you go to? Are you more of a lower body?
He's already got it going on.
Shake it.
Like that. All right, everybody. It is Dance Party Friday. We want
if we can get everybody at the Hard Rock Hotel to move and shake a little bit. We'd love to see the stormtroopers. Here we go.
Got to be fresh from the fight. Buddy the hero. Holding on for a hero till the morning light. He's gotta be sure and he's gotta be soon. Got to be larger than life. Where have all the good men gone? And where are all the gods? Where's the streetwise Hercules?